Hello everyone. In today's video, we are going to cover one of the most interesting topic of Ansible, that is custom Ansible module. First, let's talk about Ansible modules. Modules are standalone unit of code that execute specific tasks on managed nodes. They are fundamental building blocks within the playbook and play a crucial role in automation workflow. Essentially, Ansible modules are responsible for performing the actual operation. When we write tasks in a playbook, these tasks invoke modules to carry out operation as defined, directly impacting the target environment. Python is the preferred language for creating Ansible module due to several advantages. Firstly, Python's compatibility with JSON allows for seamless data handling. JSON is a widely used format for data exchange, and Python built-in libraries make it seamless to work with JSON data. Why is Python recommended? Because Ansible itself is written in Python, which means it has a native support for executing Python code. This makes Python a natural choice for creating Ansible module. Additionally, Python is known for its simplicity, readability, and extensive standard library, making it a powerful tool for module development. Now that we have covered the advantages of using Python for Ansible module, let's move on to a practical demonstration. We are going to create an Ansible module that we can add or remove user on a Linux system. This playbook ensures that user Nickel is present or absent on the system using the custom module called user management. The first task adds the user, while second task removes the user based on the desired state, absent or present. Here's the code for our custom module. Let's break it down step by step. First, module util library is imported to provide access to the Ansible module class, as it uses to handle module arguments, inputs, outputs, and errors. Next, we define function called manageUser. This function takes three arguments: module, username, and state. Depending upon the value of the state, it runs either the user add or user delete to create or delete the user. The run underscore command function execute the specified command and ensure that error is being raised if the command failed. Next, we define the main function. In the main function, we set up the module parameter defined as a dictionary. We specify the username as a required string, and the state must be either present or absent. Based on these parameters, we call the manageUser function to handle the user creation or removal. Finally, the exit.json method is called to return the result of the module execution. Now let's switch over to the virtual machine to see how the Ansible module is structured. So here is the RHEL 9.4 machine is deployed. And Ansible is already installed here. And if you are unsure how to install Ansible, I have another video that walks you through the installation process. Be sure to check that out. Let's first create an Ansible workspace or directory. So let's create a directory called Ansible-module. So inside that directory, we need to create one folder or directory called library, because Ansible always look for a library folder in case of a custom modules. So first we need to create a directory called library. And inside that we need to place our custom module. We need to create a file name with the name which is provided in the playbook. So in our example, we use a name called user management in the playbook. The same name should be used for the file creation of the custom module, that is a usermanagement.py. If you see, I have already created a file called usermanagement.py, and the same name has been used here. So I will replicate the same over there. I will create a file called usermanagement.py under the library folder, and I will paste all the content of my code here. Okay. Now go back one directory. So I need to place my Ansible code here. So this is the code to create a user called Nickel. So user add.yml. So this particular playbook will be using the user management custom module and creating a user called Nikhil. So let's first verify, is this user already there? So this user is not been created. So let's trigger the playbook. User add. So user got created successfully. So let's verify that. Yeah, user got created. So this is the playbook which internally calls the custom module which we created to use the user add command, because we specify the present state over there. Now let's try to delete the same user. Okay, I am going to create another playbook called user delete. User delete.yml. So this particular playbook will be deleting the user called Nikhil. Ansible hyphen playbook user del, and it got deleted successfully. Let's verify that using the same command. Yeah, user got deleted successfully. Now that we have learned how to create a custom module, it's important to focus on the best practices for custom module creation. So first, clear module naming. Choose the descriptive name for your modules that indicate their purpose and functionality. Input format consistency. Maintain a consistent format for your input parameters across your modules. This improves readability and usability. Error handling and messages. This means implement proper error handling to provide informative messages and avoid abrupt failures. Testing methodologies. Develop tests for your module to validate its functionality and catch potential issues early. Last but not the least, consistent indentation. Maintain consistent indentation level. It helps in quickly identifying code blocks and their hierarchies. Before we wrap up, I encourage you to create writing your own Ansible module using the best practices we have covered. For more detailed guidance, check out my blog on the custom Ansible module creation. I will add the link in the description. Thank you for joining. I hope you found it valuable. And if you have any question or need further assistance, feel free to reach out. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Share your own custom module example, or if you have any question, just put it in the comment section. Thank you. Have a nice day.